In this lesson, I will explain to you how to find out the depreciation by using the sum of years method, and it is the easiest method as well. So first of all, I will explain to you what I have written here, then we will solve it with the help of example. So sum of the years digit method of depreciation is one of the accelerated depreciation technique. Now, what is the meaning of accelerated depreciation techniques? It means in the first year, the value of your asset will depreciate more compared to second year, third year, and fourth year. Suppose if our value of our asset will depreciate, suppose 500 in the first year, then maybe it will depreciate 350 in the second year, 200 in the third year, and so on. And at the end of the year, and the end of the third year or fourth year, I will show you, you have to keep your salvage value. And what is the salvage value? The value at the end of the useful life of the assets. So this is called the using the sum of the years depreciation method. This is the accelerated depreciation technique, which are based on the assumption that assets are generally more productive when they are new and their productivity decreases as they become old, right? And we know very well, if suppose we will buy any machinery, definitely it will produce more in the first few years and then its productivity decreases as the time passes. So sum of the years digit method is accelerated depreciation. Depreciation is taken as a fraction part of the sum of the years. Now, what is the meaning of this? It means if we have a equipment or machinery or anything, if the useful life of that machinery is 5 years, suppose, so you have to add 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. What is this? These are the years. First year, second year, third year, fourth year, and fifth. If suppose we have 4 years, so you have to add 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4, right? And here we are using 5 years. That is why we have to use 1 plus 2 plus 3, and the total is 15. Now, where we have to use this 15, I will show you. In order to calculate the depreciation by using sum of the years depreciation method, you have to make this table. There should be 6 columns, beginning book value, total depreciation cost, depreciation rate, and expense, accumulated depreciation, ending book value. Now, how to fill this table? I will show you one by one. First of all, you have to find out what is the value of your asset. Suppose the value of our machinery or equipment, whatever we have purchased, is 1000. So this is called the beginning book value. And here I have written 200 is the salvage value, meaning is when we will sell this equipment at the end of the 5 year, because the useful life is 5 years, we will get $200. This is called the scrap value or the salvage value. So 1000 minus 200 is 800. We have to write down 800 here. Every year, 800, 800, 800, and so on. Right, now we have to find out the depreciation rate. So here we will use sum of the years. Our sum of the years, I told you, it was 15. 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4. So it is, when we will add it, it is 15. Now, in the how we will find out the depreciation rate of the first year? So we will start from the last year, because we have 5 years, 5 divided by 15 for this multiply by 100. For the second year, 4 divided by 15 multiply by 100. Similarly, for the third year, you do not have to start from 1. From the first year depreciation, always we will come back from the last 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. So here I have written the same thing for you, so you can see easily. 5 divided by 15. What actually we are doing here? We are finding out the depreciation rate. So this is the depreciation rate, and then you have to multiply by 100. So in the first year, our machinery or equipment will depreciate 33.33% of 800, which is equal to 266.67. In the second year, it is 4 divided by 15. It will not remain the same. It is the accelerated method. So in the second year, it will depreciate by 26.56% of $88,800, which is equal to 213.33, and so on. And here I have made the complete table for you. So see here, the fourth column is the accumulated. Accumulated means total. In the first year, it is depreciated by $266.67. In second year, you have to add this. It will be 480. 480 plus 160, which is 640, and so on. So at the end of the year, at the end of the fifth year, you will see $800, right? Why 800? See here, we have $800 is the total depreciation cost. 200 is the salvage value, which we have to keep at the end of the fifth year. And this is the ending balance. How you will find out this? So initial value is 1000. It is A minus D. This is the D column. 1000 minus first year depreciation. So this is the ending. And you know, ending value will be the opening value of the next year or next month. So this is the beginning balance. This minus D, which is equal to 520. Ending book value. Now this is remaining. And then 520 minus D column. This is the depreciation expense of the third year, 360. And then we will subtract it. You will see at the end, ending book value is $200. This is the total depreciation cost. This is the salvage value, which you have to keep at the end of the fifth year. So this is called the sum of the years digit method. For your practice, I have made a question. The value of your asset is $45,000. Salvage value is $5,000. And here you have to use 4 years. It means I will give you the hint. 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4, which is equal to 10. Right? So first year depreciation, you have to start from here. 4 divided by 10 multiplied by 100. This is the depreciation rate for the second year. This and then and so on. Right, you have to depreciate when you will make the total of the accumulated. It should be 40,000 because 45 minus 5,000. And at the end, the last figure of your last column should be 5,000 because this is the salvage value or the scrap value. Now do your own, practice it, involve. When you will involve it, you will get more. After this, you have to subscribe to my channel, like it, and click on the bell icon so you will get the next video easily. Thank you.